And creepers and groves like Vrindavan, mountains like Gira and North, everything. You can sing one kirtan. This will help you.
Yes.
You can bring. Always, you just would bring some flowers, one mala for Bhagavatam, do aarti, and then we will begin. Daily this would be done. Beginning and in end also. Also, from tomorrow you should bring chandan. Chandan, you know? Yes. Malaya chandan. And three tulsi patram in a bell. जानता नहीं है यह सब नियम कानून नहीं जानता है, इनसे कह करके ऐसा करना चाहिए। जय जय राधा कृष्ण जुगल मिला बाई सेटिंग यू नो डोंट यू नो I don't want that always you should see books and then you remember? Yes, you should.
Jaya Jaya Radha Krishna Yugala Mila.
Jaya Jaya Radha Krishna Yugala Mila.
Thank you.
Nityanandasya Jnanam Janasalakaya
Chakshurunmilitam Jena Tasmai Shri Guru Vanchakalpatarvyasya Krita Sindhu Vevasa Patitanam Pavanenya Vaishnavenya Namo Mahabhadanaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Gaura Krishna Bhaktya Vihina Aparatha Lakshaya Chitta Sarvamaditaranga Swam Sharanam Prapanna
Vinde Namaste Charanarvindam
Gurave Gaura Chandraya Radhikaya Tadalaya Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tadabhaktaya Namo Yam Prabhrajantam Anupetam Apeta Krityam Dvaipāyano virahakātaryājimā Putreti tanmaitaya tarbho bhinedu Tam sarvabhūtavidayam munimānatushtam Tamayivāsmi tavayivāsmi Najināmi tvayāmiya Iti vidyairādhe tamnaimāmasya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Vasa Adi Shri Gaur Bhaktavinoda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama Rama Hare
Yeah. Beginning Srimad Bhagavatam Hari Katha, Krishna Katha. I have told the Bhagavad Katha from one canto to nine canto in England and so many places. I want to begin Hari Katha, Bhagavad Katha. From Narada Rishi, but at once I will come to 10th canto Bhagavata, from the birth of Krishna and Vidhi. See, there are so many basic principles of bhakti. And in Bhagavatam, it has been established the service of Krishna. Anywhere it was not established in Vedas, Puranas, Upanishads, and any Gita, Mahabharata, and by the mercy of Narad, Vyas realized that why he is not happy. And then he compiled Bhagavatam. How this can? First I will explain all these things. First of all, you should know that Srimad Bhagavat is not a book, simply book, made of paper and ink. It is more important than Vedas, Upanishads and all. It means that Krishna is himself. This is the embodiment of Krishna. The 12 parts of the body of Krishna is 12 cantos. Especially His heart is tenth. And in heart, five kinds of air, like pran, is there. Without pran, a body cannot be. So five prans are like five chapters of Srimad Bhagavatam, 10th canto, from 29 to 33, and they are called Ras Pancha, Dhyayi Panch Pran. So we'll explain all these things. First of all, I'm coming a very brief relation with my Gurudev and Swamiji. Our Guru Maharaj left this world, his relation with worldly relations, mother and brother and everything, in 1916, and he came to Mayapur, and he met with Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami. He was very beautiful, very soft, but very energetic and intelligent. He used to serve Srila Prabhupada, and he became very much pleased, happy with this new energetic boy. He gave first initiation, that is Harinam, in 1960. But later on, our Guru Maharaj left his college and gave up his study because he saw that the professors and principals, they cannot understand the philosophy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Though in MA there was subject, Chaitanya Chaitamrita, Srimad Bhagavatam as subjects, but they could not understand the meaning. Vadanti tattva vidas tattvam yati jnanam advayam brahmeti paramatmeti bhagavaneti shabdete. Also in Chaitanya Chaitamrita, Jivira Sarupa Nitya Krishna Das, Krishnera Tatastha Sakti Bheda Bheda. What is called Bheda Bheda Prakash? What is Tatastha Sakti? And Vadanti Tattva Vidas Tattam Jajjnanam Advayam. What is Advayam? They cannot explain. They used to come to our Gurudev. He was like a student. But they used to come to him, that he should explain all these things. So he thought that no use of reading in these schools and colleges. So he left the college and joined the movement of his Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami. Now we see that serving Swamiji for 16 or more than 24 years, serving him, and having renounce order, but yet they feel that we should take a study in colleges. In America, I am seeing that so many senior Vaishnavas of Swamiji are now joining colleges, learning all bad kinds of philosophies, impersonal philosophies, and other things. But I think it is no, that they have no at all belief in Swami. They are Gurudev also. So he left the college and joined forever the mission of his Gurudev, serving him. Swamiji, Bhaktivedanta Swamiji, met his Gurudev in 1922. He was also so intelligent. Especially he was very qualified in English literature. So Prabhupada gave him, told him to write articles in Back to Godhead. That was the harmonist. And he should serve. And you can preach in English. They were, from then, they become friends. Once, but he joined in Calcutta, Bengal Chemical, and he became manager of that company. Gurudev was serving in Mayapur and Calcutta. His Gurudev, always living with Gurudev. Once there was a parikrama in Navadvip. About thousands of pilgrims were there. They were doing parikrama with Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur. In front of all pilgrims, a very big elephant was there, and Gaur Nityananda Prabhu or Radha Krishna were on the back of that elephant, so decorated. And all were singing Kirtan, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara and Hare Krishna and all Kirtans. They crossed the Ganges and came in the middle of Navadvip. There is a Shivigraha of Jog Maya, Praudha Maya. She came from upper side, from Mayapur. She was at first. Vriddha Shiv and this Jog Maya, Praudha Maya, were at first in Mayapur. But a flood came so much, it destroyed everything and took in water whole Mayapur, except in the birthplace of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So, all inhabitants came in the other bank. And also she was brought to this Navadvip town that is called Koladvip. So he was there. His preaching was very solid, strong. He used to speak truth. No compromise with Sahajiya, Sakhidheki, Asmartha Brahman and all others. No compromise. All enthusiastic youngs were following Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. So many. He was on the opinion of Daiva Varnashram Dharma. You know Daiva Varnashram Dharma? Mm-hmm. India now, smart Brahmanism is there. Those who have come in Brahman family, they will Brahmin. Whether they are not following the rules and regulations of Brahmanism. Those who know Brahma, Krishna is Brahman actually. This is the rule. But those who are not following this, coming only in the bonds, dynasty of Brahman, then he is called Brahman. Whether he doesn't know A-I-E-E or Anuswar and Dishar or anything. They have no belief in Krishna or any manifestations of Krishna. But yet they tell them Brahman. Highest in all costs. Prabhupada told that those have come in the dynasty of Vans, of Brahmins, but they are not acting as a Brahman. They are actually no Brahman. They are Shudra. And those who have come anywhere, in any caste, but they are Bhakta, devotees, they are actually Brahmin. More than Brahmin. They should be honored. Not all bogus persons, coming only in Brahmin family, but not actually knowing Brahma or doing Bhakti. Also, the Goswamis, in their also family, not doing actually devotion of Krishna, not worshipping Krishna. They take mind, flesh, fish and all these things. But even they think that we are Goswami, in the line of Rupa Goswami. Prabhupada told very strongly, opposed this, and told anyone who is coming in the family of Goswami are not family. Not Goswami. Sanatana Goswami has no family, Rupa Goswami has no family, any of the six Goswami has no family, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu left his world, no son, no family, no daughter. Advaita Taj has rejected his eight sons, only Achyutananda was he adopted, and he has no marriage, he has also no. Nityananda Prabhu, after Birchandra, he has no son or nothing. So from where these Goswami came? Actually, they are not following the rules and regulations of Goswami, not had no devotional services, not chanting, nothing. They are taking flesh and they were worshipping Devi, Durga Devi and all others. So they are not Goswami. They are not actually Goswamis. So all became against of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami. So they attacked there with soda bottles, stones, chips of stones, warm water, and they wanted to kill Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. Don't take sleep like sheep like this. Otherwise, don't sit easy. Like this, like this. Then we will do like this. And you plan. Give me 10 days for me. 1 hour is mine. Don't think it is yours for testing easiness and.
It is 23 hours they can sleep.
You can sleep. Rest 23 hours. But 1 hour should be given to you. Pakka, you know?
100%.
Don't sleep, don't chop and don't do anything. Very patiently you should hear me. If you will hear, it is guaranteed that you will have bhakti. It is guaranteed. Your Krishna bhakti will be improved. And you will never fear for anything. Will be like Parikshit Maharaj. Try to hear all these things like Parikshit Maharaj. I am not Sukhdev Goswami, but I have seated on the same ashram. I have also no desire like him, nothing desire, only desire for me to serve Radha Krishna, Gaur Nityananda Prabhu. So, they wanted to kill, all ran away from there. All were saying their moan, that how we should
save
ourselves. None was saying that Prabhupada was there. But there was one disciple. He was standing by him, all day. And he saw that so many stones, soda bottles and all are coming, water, everything. He
protected.
Taking all the stones and soda bottles, and he knew one devotee who was nearby. He took Srila Prabhupada with him and entered that house. they shut up the door, they close the door, and there that disciple, Vinod Bihari Brahmachari, our Gurudev, he prayed him that you should give your clothes to me and take my clothes and I will try to easily take away from here to Mayapur at once. Otherwise, we cannot sell it. Prabhupada, anyhow, he accepted. And he took all the clothes of our Gurudev, white dress. Our Guru Maharaj used to be in very fine dress, like Babu. Jamindar family, you know?
Landlords.
Lord family. A stick in his hands, very beautiful. This
expensive cloth.
He used to ride on horses, very beautiful horse. So, Prabhupada used to love and affects, love him so much. So he took the white dress of our Gurudev and he gave his red cloth, everything is done to our Gurudev. And thus he was set and he was safely he returned to Mayapur. And after that Gurudev, keeping his hands in his life in hands, anyhow, police came and set him. And he, anyhow, all thought that he is Prabhupada. And they wanted to kill him. So, Prabhupada became so much happy and satisfied to our Gurudev. So, he was in Mayapur and serving Gurudev. Like Rupa Goswami sat. He became the manager of Patrika, Dainik Nadia Prakash, Gauriya. He was a very learned person. He was a poet, burned poet. You can see his Tulsi Aarti and all other things. But after the disappearance of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, a black period came in our Saraswat Gauriya Vaishnava. So many devotees began to return to their homes, having marriage and worldly life. Like when Srila Bhaktivedanta Swamiji left this world, so many devotees returned to their homes, they married and they became home. And some of them were here and there, no inspiring, nothing. Some left this practice, bhakti yoga also. So everything was upset. Periodical papers, monthly papers like Gaudiya, Harmonist, Bhagavat Patrika were stopped. Parikrama was stopped. Everything was stopped. Srila Prabhupada told our Gurudev when he was Brahmachari. He has given sannyas before. I told this was real sannyas. But anyhow he told that. In dream he told that. Why you are not taking sannyas? Everything is going to be upset. You should at once take sannyas. So, he left Gaudiya Mission at that time. And he came to Bagh Bazar, Calcutta and established Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti in 1941. And one of the prominent person was this Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, Abhay Charanand Vinda at that time. At that time, Vaishnava has given him Bhakti Vedanta title also. So our Guru Maharaj established Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti. Vedanta is not Shankaracharya Vedanta. Especially Vedanta is Bhakti. To establish this in this world, he established Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti. Swamiji Maharaj has written us in a letter this fact, that I was also one of the three prominent person who established Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti, and since I am serving in Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti, he was chief editor in charge of our Gaudiya Patrika and Bhagavat Patrika, in which I was editor. In both I was editor, so he was chief editor. And he used to write so many articles in two papers. And he was a very famous person. He met me in very early, in 1947, after our parikrama was done, Navadvip parikrama. I went with my Guruji to Calcutta. Guru Maharaj was so much pleased to keep me as his personal servant. I used to always cook, wash his clothes, so many services, and always noting everything what he uttered. At that time I did not know Bengali. I learned Bengali to read Jaiva Dharma, to read Chaitanya Chaitamrita. I served him in so many ways. He was so much pleased to me. After some time he gave sannyas. So I met him, Swamiji, in Calcutta, Bagh Bazar, in Boshpada Lane. Swamiji came there, very big personality. They joking modes with my Gurudev. They said, they sit on the same ashram. Gurudev was his sannyasi and he was grihastha. But yet, they both were sitting on the same platform. And as if they are very bosom friends, I saw them joking towards each other. And they were so much immersed in Hari Katha. From that very beginning, I was well known to Swamiji. He asked me, from where you have come? What is your name? And so on, so many questions. And he was very much happy with me. After that, when we meet, he used to love me so much. After that, Swamiji met me in Mathura in early in 1954. At that time, he was telling me that I went to Srila Prabhupada. He used to love me. But I was so fearful to read one slok of Srimad Bhagavatam. Yada jasya grahnati harishe taddham shanai. That if anyone takes shelter of Krishna, then Krishna make him a street beggar. So I was thinking, and was so fear that if I am chanting, remembering Krishna and hearing Harikatha, doing so much all these services to Krishna, then I will have to poor. I was fearing. And suddenly I saw that I lost my job in Bengal committee. I resigned from there and came to Allahabad and established another medical factory. But he fell again after 1 year. Then he established a very good shop of medicine in where Jawaharlal Nehru, that Prime Minister of India, Indira Gandhi, used to come to his shop. But After some time, he also lost that shock. He became more fearful. He wanted to begin other jobs, but everywhere. He was telling, oh, Srimad Bhagavata is true. Then there, his wife and children also kicked him because he was not giving any money to them. So he came to Mathura in our Keshavji Gaudiya Math. I served him because I knew that he was very bosom friend of my guru. I served him by cooking myself, by giving all kinds of services to him. And he was writing Chaitanya Charitamrita. He has written in his letter also. Back to Godhead he was doing. After this, I had a proposal to him that your wife and children have rejected you. You have lost everything. Then why you are waiting for these all things? What do you want? I pray you that just take sannyas. Then he told this story. I was praying for this. I think that by the wish of God and Guru and Gauran, I will have to take perhaps this for which I was fearing for so long. He has also accepted in his letter that it was Narayan Maharaj who constantly told me to take sannyas. At last Gurudev came at that same time. And I requested my Gurudev, please request Pavacharanath Prabhu to take sannyas. Then he was agreed, and on the Vishwarup Khor day, he took sannyas there. I made him danda, his danda. I made this all things, and I was priest at there. And after that, he came to America, Boston perhaps, Portport.
Yes, Boston.
And after that he came to New York, 22nd Avenue, and he began to preach. Very soon he preached over the whole world. If there was no power of Krishna, anyone cannot preach like that. So he was not ordinary person. He used to love me also, because when he returned from England first time, only I was the person to receive him in
airport.
And taking prasad with him, first time, Kirtananand was there, and Achyutanand came from Calcutta. He ordered me to preach because he was not feeling so. So I went in Delhi so many times to preach. After that he ordered me to send his all books, everything, to New York, 2nd Avenue. I served him. In the last day, when he was going from this world, he called me very honorably, and took my hand in his hands and told that you should help my mission, all the disciples. And one thing I request you, that with your own hand you should give me
Samadhi.
And after Samadhi, Birah Mahotsav will be done by you also. And after that, you should always try to help my devotees. I did it to my best capacity. Still, I am in the same way. I want that ISKCON should be flourish. I want to help them. Though they don't want to take my help, but I am saying that if they are not taking help of any good devotees,
they cannot live long. They will lose their faith. So only association of very bona fide good Vaishnav can save anyone. It is so important. Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Shastra God. Law Matra Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Shidhya. Everything. I told Shamless all these things about me. Only to tell that I am a very very unworthy servant of Swamiji. I have so much relations with him. Though I was unworthy, but he accepted me. And I accepted him like my Shiksha Guru. I honored him his whole life. I served him and helped him in so many ways. So, now some thing is coming from the devotees of ISKCON that I have not served actually him, no relation at all. False, bogus, some things come, but I don't care for it. I'm still in the same mood to serve. I've come also. I came last time, first time also. I took the dust of Swamiji's lotus feet everywhere when where he went. But by this, some problem came from for ISKCON. And they told me not to go anywhere in their mutts. I know that there is no their mutts, all is of Swamiji. I have right to go anywhere because I think myself his first disciple. So any man cannot take this thing. Anyone cannot take any God brother's mood. They cannot control. They can tell that you should not come, but how anyone can take the respect of his Gurudev, that you cannot serve him? Anyone has no right to take it. All disciples have this right, strongly, to serve his Gurudev. Where not being in any mud or out of mud. In this temple they will serve their Gurudev, no harm. So, again, perhaps he has dragged me here. I want to help the devotees as much as I can. I think that in 11 days now, beginning from today, will always glorify Srimad Bhagavatam, Gita and all other things. Krishna Katha. From 10 countries. Now we will do any kirtan, and after that 10 minutes. Any kirtan?
Sri Krishna Chaitanya.
Thank you.
yourself help in a tune.
Jai Jai Radha Ramana Diva.
Rishis and Maharshis, very learned persons, always remembering Krishna. So they were all afraid of this. They were thinking what to do. In Kali Yuga, all the persons will give up good qualities. There will be materialistics, always enjoying all material happiness, especially wealth, wine and women or men. They have no belief, they will have no belief in Krishna. They will try to develop so many things. They will do so much progress in worldly life, especially communication and transportation. In medical lines,
a very wonderful change will come. They were thinking. The wives, the women will be quite free. There will be characterless, having no good qualities, always changing husbands, involved in material things, also men, no bhakti, no Vedic culture. They will always be involved in worldly things. Son will honor their father and mother. Fathers and mothers will be like same, always engaged in testing worldly things. The Brahmins will give up their Brahminism, devotion and everything. The persons will be called learned, who will tell false things, chattering worldly things. The women will be only think, they will think that if you will decorate our hairs, it will be so beautiful. They will follow no rule and regulation. They will color their lips and they will think to use so many artificial things for making their beauties. But the beauty of their inner thing will go away. Men will always cheat others and very, very selfishness. At that time, what should I do? They were thinking this way. At once Brahma suggested them to go to Naimisharanya. And they should do anything for Kali Yuga. They assembled there and they were thinking what to do. They were doing sacrifices, fire sacrifices. They did so much that all environment became black. Their body also became black. Inner, outer of their body also became black. In the meantime, Baldev Prabhu came. Lomharsan Sut was there. And he was reading Purans. And they were, all the rishis were doing fire sacrifice. He was reading Purans. When Baldev Prabhu came, all the rishis and maharshis, very learned, they stood up and welcomed Baldev Prabhu. But this fellow, reading Purans, sitting on the asana of Vyas, they could not honor. Even he could not stand up. So he, by his hand, he cut his
neck.
And he fell his head there. He was dead. Rishis were weeping, why you did so, Baldev Prabhu? You are himself God. He told that he is not qualified to read Bhagavatam or any Puran and to be a teacher. If he is not honoring Guru, Vaishnava, I'm thinking himself that I'm so learned in Bhagavatam and Quran, he's not qualified. He should not sit on the chair of any Vaishnava. What do you want? They wanted. If you want, I can give life to this person. They told me, no, we don't want. But we want that there should be anyone who can read Purans in our society. Lomasan Sut had a very little son. His name was Ugrasavasuta. He was at that time of 5 years old. Baldev Prabhu keep his hand on that boy and inspired him. Mercifully, began to recite all the Vedas, Upanishads, all the Purans and Upanishads, everything. And he made him to sit on the throne and to speak Purans and everything. This Ugrasavasu was fortunate to attend the Harikatha in the council of Parikshit Maharaj, told by Sukadeva Goswami. So all rishis were there and he was reading Srimad Bhagavatam. So he is telling. He told pranam to his Gurudev, Sukadeva Goswami. Yang prapajantam anupetam apetakrittam dvaipayano virahakatar ajuhav putreti tanmayataya taravobhinedi tam sarva bhuta vidayam muni mahanapusha. Bring pranam to his Gurudev, he began to tell Harikatha. The purpose of this shloka is that he is praying to his Gurudev that when he took birth, at once there was no sanskar. You know sanskar? If anyone has this sacred sanskar of Upanayan, then he can read Srimad Bhagavatam or Upanishad or any mantra he can utter, otherwise no. So he has not caught his link with her mother. He was not pure. Coming from his womb of her mother, he at once ran to forest. His father Vyasadeva was calling him, oh son, where you are? He did not reply to anything, but instead of him, the forest echoed, who is son? Oh son, oh son. No relation of son and father. Who is father? Who is son? Who is wife? Who is husband? All these relations are false. Why you are calling son? Hirani entered in the very deep forest. He saw that there were some ladies, naked quite, taking bath in a very sacred pond. Vyas was persuading his son, and Sukadeva Goswami was going. The girls were naked. They did not care for Sukadeva Goswami. He was a boy like 16 years old. He was in his mother's womb 16 years. And now he was beautiful, young, naked, quiet, going. The lady saw, but no effect. They were, as usually, they were taking bath. But when Vyas came, he was an old person, big, white hairs, and big hairs, white hairs. He came, the ladies became simple, and they came out of the water and they took their clothes and smiled a very shameful way. They began to apologize. They apology to Vyasadeva. But they told that I wondered that my son was going, he was at the age of 16, very young. You did not any shame for my son. But I am so old that You are like daughters of daughters of daughters to me. I am so much older than 400 years age, like. But you are selling it from me. They told that you are asking from us that why we are selling. And you are saying that we are girl. But he has nothing to do with us. No question, he thought that they are like dry woods. And then Vyas was so worried, he returned to home, his cottage, and wondered how I can again call this my son, because I have completed Srimad Bhagavatam. In this world, I am saying that no one is qualified to read this, to study this. This boy is actually very qualified. Nothing, no attachment for worldly things. No attachment. He does not know that I am his father. Anyone is his father. And no attachment. No clothes, quite naked. No shame at all. And he is realized so. So if I can charm him, and anyhow I will manage to bring that my son return in my cottage, I can try to study.
Make him teach him.
Teach him Srimad Bhagavatam. So one day he was saying that some hunters were going in the forest. He called them. Why you are going to forest? They told that we are hunters. We go to take any birds and parrots, so many things, deer, we hunt them. We can take their fleshes, or we can take parrots and all other birds, and we sell to others for maintaining our lives. Oh, I will give you mantra. You should try to be my disciple, and I will give a very powerful mantra that easily you will be successful in catching birds and doing all things. He wrote some verses, and he told that you should remember this verse. Varaha pidam natavarabhu karnayo karnikaram vipradabhasa kanaka kapisham vajayanti yamalam arandhrana venuradarsutaya purayan gopa vrindai vrindarannam sabadaramanam pravishatagetadru. He taught them how to pronounce it very lovely and offensive. Their voice was so sweet. He selected some hunters who were young, and he taught them first shloka. And he told that you should go and in forest you should loudly sing this mantra. Automatically, so many birds will come, so parrot and all others. They went in forest and loudly they sang this shlok. It is the shlok in which Krishna highest beautifulness is told there. How Krishna is beautiful. Like a very Kishore boy, having flutes, very affectionately seeing, searching anything, calling in Bansi, having
peacock
feather here,
some Vaijayanti mala here from neck to feet. One flower. Kaner phul means?
Yellow flower.
His mouth, the mouth of the flower always towards sun. Always. So it will move. The mouth of the flower will also move towards sun. Yellow. Krishna body is like Shyam. And this flower is yellow. So very beautiful matching. Keeping one flower here. And sometimes that very flower here, like a very beautiful young personality. Covered and surrounded by so many sakhas there. And all are telling him, sadhu, sadhu, hearing his flute. All are chanting. Even all are charmed. Not only men and women, but all the animals are here. When they were shouting this mantra, uttering, at first they saw that so many parrots, so many birds were in their triumph. They become so pleased. At once this Sukh Goswami also came. And he was telling, where you have got this shloka? Who taught you? He told that there is a rishi, his name is Delabhyas. He has taught him this. Can you ask him? This is the beauty of that Supreme Personality of Godhead. What are his quality? You should ask and tell me another day. When they returned, they were so happy and they made Vyasa and told one Sukh, a boy came of 16, very beautiful, and he has asked that you have told the beauty of Krishna, but can you tell the qualities of Krishna? How is, what are the his qualities? Then Vyasadeva taught, again taught one shloka. And that shloka was Aho Bakiyam Stanakalakutam Jighansaya Payadayatta Shadvi Leve Gatim Tanudhatu Chitantato Kangva Dayalum Saranam Rajim. The meaning of this shloka was that Putana was denting the bloods of newborn childs, murdering them, choosing, shocking the bloods, always killing boys here and there. She was so cruel. She took so much with her soul and life. And thus met him. His mother, he poured his soul. And forever he made like his mother. So in this world, there is not anyone merciful like Krishna. Anyone can go to him and he will never give up. He will accept all. Whether he will be demon, not demon, animal, anything he be. But those who will go to Krishna, Krishna will chop and purify his heart and give liberation easily. What to tell of liberation? He will give his own service in Braja. So he is Sukadeva. At once attracted, and he came running to his father. Where is that old person? And he came nearby to Vyasa and fell flat on the horse's feet of Vyasa. I want to read the book in which you have compiled all these things. I want to hear. I want to read, study the book. He has admitted in Srimad Bhagavatam that I was impersonal. What?
Impersonalist.
But by the mercy of Vyas, he taught me Srimad Bhagavatam. And I became Rasika Bhakta Vaishnava. So I want to give some Krishna Katha from that Srimad Bhagavatam. From tomorrow, I will try to explain Srimad Bhagavatam. The characteristics of Krishna, Balya Leela, Pauvandya Leela, and Kishore Leela. In them, there are so many teachings of bhakti and everything. So you should hear it patiently. The glories of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and everything will come in that. Gaur Praman. Now you can do a kirtan, and after kirtan, you can do aarti here. And after aarti, do parikrama. In morning, also there will be car class. If I will be open, then I will do 10 minutes or 15 minutes. Otherwise, any devotee, like Nirgun Prabhu, Gopinda Prabhu, Shyam Rani, Rukam Prabhu,
Govinda Prabhu, Govinda Prabhu, Prabhu,
Prabhu, and so many are qualified Vaishnava. We will hear from them. And in morning, tomorrow, I want to take darshan of the deity where I used to go in morning. If it will be, I will tell some harikatha little. If it has been offered, if it is not offered, then it is offered to deity, then bring. Then I will do so.
Has this been offered?
Already offered?
Already offered?
Prabhu's Gurudev is going to our local temple tomorrow morning, and he'll come at 7 o'clock tomorrow morning to take darshan of the deities and maybe to say something. So you're all welcome to come.
here.
I'm happy to meet you.
One of the very first disciples of Srila Prabhupada.
You are my god sister.
Older than you.
Are you guys
your thoughts
so much?
I gotta get my
shoe. Go ahead. I'm getting my shoe. Yeah, I'm going. I gotta get it.
Everyone should stay for RT. I know it's hard, but we need to stay for RT.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yeah, I just left it right.